In the last session, we have solved problem 4 on issue of shares at par, including calls in arrears and calls in advance. In this session, we shall solve problem 5 with oversubscription. Now, the first, before we take up the problem, what is this oversubscription? Oversubscription means when the company issues the shares, applications received from the public are more than the issue. Like, company has issued 10,000 shares, but the applications received are 12,000. Shares issued are 10, applications received are 12,000. How many are excess applications? 2,000. This is called as oversubscription. Then the question arises, what is to be done with this excess application? What is to be done with this oversubscription? Let's see what is to be done with that. Oversubscription is nothing but excess applications received. Now the next question is, what should we do with this excess application? We have three options. The excess application what we have received is to be rejected and the money should be refunded. As I give the example, 10,000 of the shares issued, applications received are 12,000. How much the excess? 2,000. Reject that. That is, whatever application money we have received on that extra 2,000, refund it back to the applicants. This is the first, what we can do with that. Second, the next what we can do is, the excess application money, we can adjust it to allotment. Say for example, application is 10 rupees. How many excess applications as per the example? 2,000. So 2,000 into 10, 20,000 extra amount we have received. First option, adjust, refund it directly. Second option, adjust to allotment. That means when we move on with allotment, 20,000 already we have received. In allotment, 20,000 less we should receive. That is what is adjusted with allotment. One more what we can do is, we can show that as adjusted in or adjusted to calls in advance. It depends upon what is to be done, we'll see. But it depends upon the problem, whether it should be refunded, adjusted to allotment or adjusted to calls in advance. It will be very clearly mentioned. Is it refunded, adjusted to allotment or calls? In case the problem is silent regarding what is done with the excess application, remember, the excess applications are to be refunded if the problem doesn't mention anything. Now let us take up one problem first, wherein there will be only refund. After that we'll take a problem wherein there will be refund, adjustment to allotment and also to calls. Let us see. A company has issued 5,000 equity shares of rupees 50 each, and the amount that is receivable or payable by the applicants will be 15 rupees on application, 20 rupees on the allotment, 10 rupees on the first call, and 5 rupees on the second and final call. Further see, 6,000 applications are received, issued are 5,000. But applications received are 6,000. How much are excess applications? 1,000. Is it mentioned anything? What is to be done with the excess application? No, we have to refund it back. But in this problem, it is very clearly given that excess applications are to be rejected and refunded. Further, they are mentioned, company has not yet made the calls, nor the first call, nor the final call. So when calls are not made, we need to pass only 4 entries. What 4 entries? Application money received, money transferred after showing the refund entry. Allotment money adjusted, money received. No entries for calls because company has not yet made the calls. So the journal, particulars LF debit credit, let us see what the first entry will be. Application money received. On how many applications? 6,000. We have received the application money on 6,000. So 6,000 will multiply with the application amount.